Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen, distinguished guests and soldiers. I'm Major Neal Scott, Division Headquarters and Headquarters Battalion S3, and I want to welcome you to today's 34th Infantry Division Change of Command Ceremony. On behalf of the Commanding General, I wish to recognize several distinguished guests in attendance today. First, our government officials, former Minnesota Secretary of State Mark Ritchie, and the City of Rosemont Mayor William Drosty. We would also like to recognize the civilian aide to the Secretary of the Army, retired Major General Harry Sieben, the Adjutant General of the Iowa National Guard, Major General Timothy Orr, First Corps Deputy Commanding General, Major General Mark Stammer, and the Special Assistant to the United States Africa Commander, Major General Wertholdt Jr. We have several former 34th Infantry Division commanders with us today, Major General retired Rick Erlinson, and Major General retired David Elisario. I would also like to recognize three former Red Bull Command Sergeants Major, Command Sergeant Major retired Bob Boone, Command Sergeant Major retired Doug Juline, and Command Sergeant Major retired Joel Arnold. It is an honor to recognize the family of the commander, Ms. Cecily Loidolt and son Sam, and say welcome to the family of the incoming commander, Mrs. Cindy Jensen, son Jacob, and daughters Atlee and Keeley. The change of command ceremony is rooted in military history dating back to the 18th century during the reign of Frederick the Great of Prussia. At that time, organizational flags were developed with color arrangements and symbols unique to each particular unit. To this flag and its commander, the soldiers of the unit would dedicate their loyalty and trust. When a change of command was to take place, the flag was passed to the individual assuming the command. This gesture was accomplished in front of the unit so that all could see and witness their new leader assuming his dutiful position. He who held the flag also held the soldier's allegiance. This symbolic tradition has survived throughout military history. Major General Neal Loidolt has a distinguished record of service to his country, the United States Army, and especially the Minnesota Army National Guard. As the commander of the 34th Infantry Division, he has served in an outstanding manner throughout his tenure. Equally distinctive, Brigadier General Jon Jensen will assume command of the 34th Infantry Division. The presiding officer for today's ceremony is the commander of the Minnesota National Guard, Major General Richard Nash. The command sound adjutant's call is used by the United States Army to indicate that the adjutant, the officer responsible for accounting for soldiers and forming the unit, is about to form the command. It was first used by the Army in 1874. It advises subordinate commanders to prepare their troops for formation and follow on commands. The subordinate commands you see represented in front of you today are the 34th Infantry Division Band, commanded by Chief Warrant Officer 2 David Stordalen, 1st Brigade Combat Team, commanded by Colonel Charles Kemper, the 2nd Brigade Combat Team, commanded by Colonel Steve Osborne, the 34th Combat Aviation Brigade, commanded by Colonel Sean Mankey, the 84th Troop Command, commanded by Colonel Troy Sukup, the 347th Regional Support Group, commanded by Colonel Lowell Cruz, and the 34th Division Headquarters and Headquarters Battalion, commanded by Lieutenant Colonel Jess Ulrich.
Present.
The official party for the 34th Infantry Division Change of Command Ceremony consists of Major General Richard Nash, the Adjutant General, Major General Neal Loidolt, Commander, 34th Infantry Division, Brigadier General Jon Jensen, and Chaplain Lieutenant Colonel Buddy Wynn, 34th Infantry Division Chaplain. The Commander of Troops for today's ceremony is Colonel Mike Wickman, 34th Infantry Division Chief of Staff. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the arrival of the official party and remain standing for the invocation from Chaplain Wynn.
Good afternoon, ladies and gentlemen. Sacred text brings to mind the story of transition between Moses and Joshua as God's people prepared to move into a new season. Both men were warriors with combat experience, and they looked to God for guidance, direction, courage, strength, and wisdom to lead the people. And it is with that in mind that I invite you to join me in prayer. Almighty God, as we gather for such an auspicious occasion as this, I invite your presence to be among us as it was with Moses and Joshua. We ask your blessings upon this significant moment in the history of this great division, when the mantle of leadership is passed from Major General Loidolt to Brigadier General Jensen. For our outgoing commander, we ask, Lord, for your continued blessings as he moves into a new season with gratitude for his contributions and his commitment, and especially that of his family. For the incoming commander, we ask for wisdom and courage to make wise decisions, and then for decisiveness of action. Help him to create an environment which demands the best of all, underscores the value and human dignity of every member of the organization, and one in which challenges are fair and rewarding. May he always strive to assist every member of this division to grow and develop so that each can be the person that you intended them to be. Knowing that no leader is successful on their own, God, we offer thanks for willing staff and team contribution of both heart and talent to the success of our mission. And Lord, we offer humble gratitude for watching over the families of these leaders and all of our Red Bull soldiers, providing for their needs according to your riches and glory. Reward them with a renewed sense of contribution to our efforts, knowing that their sacrifice is not in vain. Lord, we pray that you will continue to be our helper in these days. We thank you for these brave souls, our Red Bull soldiers, who have volunteered to pick up the cause of freedom during a time of war. We thank you, Lord, for our freedoms, freedom of speech, freedom of worship, freedom from want, and freedom from fear. Bless this land we love so much, and above all, help us to remember that righteousness alone exalts a nation. You have blessed America in the past. You have made her rich. Finally, Lord, we pray that you will also make her good in your sight. We pray this in your most holy name. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. At this time, flowers are being presented to Ms. Cecily Loidolt on behalf of the soldiers of the 34th Infantry Division as a sign of gratitude for her commitment and support to the division. Mrs. Cindy Jensen is also receiving flowers as a welcome to the division command. Ladies and gentlemen, please stand for the advancement of the colors and the singing of the national anthem by Sergeant Signe Munfrum.
Colors up! Up! Assume your post and present the command.
Oh, say can you see by the dawn's early light what so proudly we hailed at the twilight's last gleaming, whose broad stripes and bright stars through the perilous fight o'er the ramparts we watched were still gallantly streaming. That our flag was still there. Oh, say, does that star-spangled banner yet wave o'er the land of the free and the home of the brave?
Hold up.
Ladies and gentlemen, please be seated. The passing of the colors symbolizes the transfer of command authority and responsibility from the outgoing commander to the new commander. It is one of the oldest traditions of the profession of arms. The passing of the colors from the command sergeant major to the outgoing commander signifies the key role of the non-commissioned officer corps as the guardian and protector of the colors and the men and women who serve to preserve glory. The passing of the colors from the outgoing commander to the senior commander signifies the relinquishing of command and heartfelt gratitude for the support, guidance, and opportunity to serve. The passing of the colors from the senior commander to the incoming commander represents the trust and confidence in the new commander's leadership and commitment to care for the organization. By authority of Army Regulation 600-20, paragraph 2 alpha, the undersigned assumes command of the 34th Infantry Division, effective 5 January 2017. Signed, Brigadier General Jon Jensen, Brigadier General Commanding. The passing of the colors from the incoming commander to the command sergeant major is his first act in command and verifies his confidence that the non-commissioned officer corps will continue to dress on the colors. Ladies and gentlemen, Major General Nash will now present the Distinguished Service Medal to Major General Loidolt. Please remain seated as the citation is read. The President of the United States of America, authorized by Act of Congress, July 9, 1918, has awarded the Distinguished Service Medal to Major General Neal G. Loidolt for exceptionally meritorious service from 6 October 2013 to 7 January 2017 to the government in a duty of great responsibility as the Commanding General, 34th Infantry Division. During his tenure as the Commanding General, Major General Loidolt implemented a revolutionary vision that fundamentally reshaped the training, operations, and employment of National Guard divisions. He led the division to the execution of 12 major training events, supported 4 additional events, prepared to mobilize more rapidly than any reserve component division headquarters in history, and changed the way National Guard divisions contribute to the mission of the total Army. Major General Loidolt's leadership made an already great organization even better. He contributed to the lives of his soldiers and officers and worked tirelessly to improve the Red Bull Division and the National Guard as a whole. Major General Loidolt's performance is in keeping with the highest traditions of military service and reflects great credit upon himself, the 34th Infantry Division, and the United States Army. Ladies and gentlemen, at this time, Command Sergeant Major Lepowski is presenting Major General Loidolt with a gift from the units who are aligned for training. Major General Loidolt is also being presented gifts on behalf of the soldiers of the 34th Infantry Division. Ladies and gentlemen, the Adjutant General, Major General Richard Nash.
Good afternoon, everyone, and thank you for your attendance at this very significant event for two great soldiers. General Seaman, great to see you, and thank you for representing the Secretary of the Army at today's event. To our former division commanders, Major General retired Rick Erlinson and Major General retired David L. Surio. Major General Loidolt, Cecily and Sam. And to Brigadier General Jon Jensen, to Cindy and Jake, Atlee and Keeley. Major General Orr, my tag battle buddy from Iowa, thank you for being here and for the great job you do with the 2nd Brigade Red Bulls in Iowa. Major General Stammer, thank you for representing the 1st Corps at this great event, and I appreciate everything you've done for our nation. To our general officers, to all the commanders that are assembled here today, and to those that were unable to make it with the Aligned for Training organizations across this span of the division's responsibilities. To Command Sergeant Major Wortham, Command Chief Knutson, Command Chief Kessler, to all of our command sergeants, majors, to our warrant officers, to our soldiers, and our airmen gathered here today, and to our retirees and the veterans organizations that are represented, and to our members of our Serving Our Troops organization that have done just stellar work over the last 10 years, and also to the members representing our Strategic Advisory Task Force, former Secretary of State Ritchie, and to Steve Hunnings, thank you for being here. A very special welcome to an individual, Mr. Jeff Egan, and his wife, Deneen, friends and colleagues of the 34th Red Bulls. Jeff served with us in a different capacity when the division was deployed. And through his efforts and efforts of his team, saved Red Bull lives and our coalition partners. Also, our very own mayor, Mr. Drosty, again, great to see you, and thanks for being a great mayor of Rosemont. Thank you. Mr. Tom Lyons, host of our Minnesota Military Radio Hour, thank you for being here, and all previous protocols that were announced earlier by our MC are recognized. Also, need a special welcome to our very own 34th Red Bull Band, and thanks for Sergeant Munfrum's great rendition of the national anthem. You know, certainly an honor again to be present as the Red Bull Division flag is being passed along to a new leader. 2017 marks a very historic year for the Red Bulls as we begin celebrating our 100th anniversary as the 34th Division. Under General Loidolt's command and leadership, our time-tested reputation for excellence has been maintained in a splendid fashion. Thanks to the hard work and dedication of nearly 23,000 citizen soldiers aligned for training across 8 different states in our own divisional units located in Minnesota. But it's now General Jensen's opportunity to lead our exceptional men and women as the Red Bulls prepare to enter a new century of service to our community, our state, and our nation. But first, to you, General Loidolt, I can say that it was difficult for me, as well as other previous division commanders, to leave command of this great division. And I imagine it must be the same for you as well. But I have witnessed over the last 3 years firsthand how your talent, his capabilities, and his commitment have turned into tremendous accomplishments. And it's fulfilling to see your stellar leadership bear real fruit and being recognized nationally and internationally as the Red Bulls are requested to support training operations worldwide. Fresh off successfully completing a series of joint and multinational exercises, you have focused intently on elevating the division's proficiency in maintaining a sustained readiness model. You led the charge to keep Red Bulls squarely in the Army spotlight by taking on difficult challenges. Over the last 3 years, the Red Bulls have gained a reputation as being immersed in the Army's full-scale exercise cycles. Your successful warfighting exercise is still referred to as how a division goes about its business and as a learning organization. Multinational exercises like Saber Strike in Lithuania, Austere Challenge in Germany, Yamasakura supporting our Japanese allies, and CONUS support to the National Training Center were vital to ensure that our nation's military leadership and our combatant commanders could count on the 34th Division to perform well under pressure overseas. During the spring of 2015, you prepared nearly 700 soldiers from the division headquarters to deploy to West Africa in support of our nation's humanitarian effort to combat Ebola. While the units ultimately did not deploy, your preparation and leadership reassured the Army and our West African community here in Minnesota that the Red Bulls could rapidly shift focus and take on a complex humanitarian mission if required. In addition to this challenging international presence, the 34th Infantry Division also took on an important domestic operational role with participating in responding to our own fires, our blizzards, and of our own first-of-a-kind avian flu epidemic response in Minnesota. And all the while, General Loidolt, you kept a watchful eye as the Red Bull soldiers returned from combat duty. Your focus on the employment of returning soldiers resulted in meaningful careers for hundreds of troops, and your expansion of the Yellow Ribbon Network throughout Minnesota ensured that our communities would be able to constructively reach out and assist our soldiers and our families, and continue to build resiliency among our formation, and continue to build readiness in our division. Major General Loidolt is a tested and accomplished warrior, challenged with tough leadership assignments throughout his distinguished career. And I'd like to take an opportunity now to recognize General Loidolt's family, Cecily and Sam, and your father, Ron and Bonnie. Thank you for your support over the last 3 years. His accomplishments, not only during this demanding assignment, but throughout his remarkable career, are yours also. The results of his leadership as division commander attest to his character and his professionalism. And I'm proud to say, job well done, General. On behalf of the Red Bulls, past, present, and future, thank you for leading this organization so well. As General Vesey was so famous in saying, it's a good outfit. General Jensen, the bar has again been raised. And the next phase of our division's legacy is in your hands. and you will have your own unique challenges and opportunities and the ability and the authority to move this organization forward and to leave your own legacy for follow-on Red Bull commanders. As Deputy Commanding General of U.S. Army Africa and previous wartime service as the Red Bull Assistant Chief of Staff G3, and during your 4 deployments, I know that you have been close to critical decisions and the subsequent positive impacts of those decisions over the last 15 years. The weight of future decisions now rests on your shoulders. The stress of command, as you know, takes its toll, but you have had a tremendous career and are superbly prepared for this assignment, and one that you have earned. I'm confident you will be successful as we face this challenging and an uncertain future for our Army, as we have continued to wrestle with force reductions, sequestration, the Budget Control Act, and a new administration. Building the resiliency that we need and being prepared for missions in an environment which I have stated for many times is less safe than after 9/11. We have and will have challenges as a nation with a smaller army and a smaller National Guard, a resurgent Russia and expanding China, in Iranian containment, and an uncertain North Korea, along with a decentralized, asymmetrical, radical terrorism around the globe. So you must have the division prepared when our nation and Army calls, and they will. As you well know, readiness is priority number one. But you have been given the most valuable and precious tool to accomplish whatever you set out to achieve, our great Red Bull soldiers. You truly understand that our nation can face any challenge. It will be tough, but through these great men and women and the leadership of our warrant officers, our non-commissioned officer corps, seasoned and tested junior and senior leaders, and our great Red Bull soldiers, the division that you take command today is a different force than those of us who have previously commanded this fine division. Your soldiers are combat tested and eager to pass on the lessons learned through 16 years of conflict to a new generation of soldier that will prepare for challenges that we have not faced before. The level of community and family support has never been stronger, and you are armed with the tools that not only ensure a capable fighting force for our state and our nation, but also a resilient force that is balanced and prepared to face any hardship. To Cindy and Jake, Allie and Keely, thank you for your support that has made this day possible. Your husband and father will continue to need your unwavering support. And to Roger and Diane, thank you for the tremendous example you have set to inspire John to serve others. You raised a true gentlemen. There will be difficult days ahead, and I am certain that the Red Bulls will be poised for the next 100 years. General Jensen, congratulations on this monumental career achievement, and I'm looking forward to supporting you in the years ahead as we shape the future with our great soldiers. And to all the men and women of the Minnesota National Guard, you have the respect and the appreciation of all Americans for what you do to protect our communities, our state, and our nation. Thank you for that. And thanks to our veterans and to our retirees for your service, and to our families and our employers. God bless all of you, and may God continue to bless the United States of America. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, Major General Neal Loidolt.
General Nash, General Jensen, General Officers, Command Sergeants Major, fellow Red Bull soldiers, family and friends of the 34th Infantry Division, and to all of those of you who have made the events today possible, thank you.
Your attendance here today on this cold, frosty January afternoon means a great deal to me, and I surely am blessed by your presence. In addition to those already mentioned, I'd like to recognize some of the following people here today. A special welcome to our Red Bull supporters from the business community, Bob Klefsis from All Star Financial, Mike Etzel from Cargill, retired Air Force Colonel Mike Ott from U.S. Bank, and some of my friends, Jake Colzer, Robert Blake, who refused a seat to sit in his assigned seat, and Jay Black, who came here all the way from Florida because it just wasn't cold enough for him. And for the past 10 years, our most dedicated crew from serving our troops. Thank you all for being here. Just a little over 3 years ago, I stood before you mindful of what lie ahead and fully comprehending that the legacy of this great division emanates from the soldiers in front of you today, and that service to country is the most noblest of causes that a young person can undertake. I stand before you today and confidently report that this division has never been more ready, never been more competent, never been more professional, nor enjoyed a better reputation throughout the Army. And in this regard, I owe sincere thanks and appreciation to the following: to Generals Nash, Elisario, Erlinson, and Trost. You have been my mentors and teachers, and I can only hope that you might consider my command tenure as just a small interest payment on the investments you made in me. To the many brigadiers I have served with, thank you for your confidence, the respect, and support that our profession requires. And to Dirk Kloss, Bill Eater, Sandy Best, and Dave Hamler, thank you for your great friendship as well. I grew so much during our service together and take great pride in our continued association. To my staff team, both here and at the state headquarters, you were truly phenomenal. You're the finest colonels and lieutenant colonels and majors and sergeants majors that the Army has to offer. Thank you. And please know that the most significant final act or performance you might afford me is the simple request that I might be able to help you at some point in the future with your career. Please, sincerely, just ask. To the brigade commanders that care for our soldiers that make this division so great, thank you for embracing my charge to put soldier care at the center of all that you do. The motivation and enthusiasm that you've instilled throughout our formation is infectious and is the very nutrition that feeds our high esprit de corps. Well done. No one could have done it finer. Thank you to our Command Sergeants Major and the NCO leadership at Echelon throughout all our formations. You are the backbone of the Army and directly responsible for the current state of our morale and readiness. I could not be more proud of your development these past 3 years. And to Joe Arnold and John Lepowski, for your steadfast example of professionalism and reminder that leading by example is a requirement, not an option. For this, I am forever grateful. Finally, to the two men who contributed the most, who sacrificed the most, and who asked for the least in terms of thanks or recognition, I cannot imagine a more perfect performance. Colonels Eric Kurska and Mike Wickman could not be more different in military experience, nor life philosophy, nor physical stature, which is why they were so perfect as my chiefs of staff. Their diversity in these areas, combined with a nearly perfectly synonymous leadership philosophy, inclusive approach to staff training, and servant leader approach to the division staff, resulted in the achievements we have realized. Simply put, I could not have asked for more. Thank you both. Ultimately, ladies and gentlemen, it is the soldiers who make us great and perform to uphold our great bull reputation. To you, the soldiers, my simple, profound thanks and respect. I struggle today to communicate what a great privilege it has been to lead this storied division, for the opportunity it has provided, and for the sheer professional satisfaction I've experienced. But it's because of this command that I met Steve Sanford in the audience here today, wounded in action in Vietnam, son of a World War II veteran who got his start in 2 of the 135. It's because of this command that I've met more four-star generals than in the entire previous 30 years of my career and have been the fortunate recipient of accolades meant for and earned by the hard work of our soldiers. Because of this command, I crossed the Volturno River with the grandson of a World War II Red Bull soldier. Staff Sergeant Dylan Jennings and I eventually met up with an 85-year-old Italian woman who hugged him and sobbed as she recalled the Red Bull soldier that gave her a chocolate bar and some food to eat, saving her and her sister from sure starvation. And it's because of this command that I finally, after 30-plus years of service, have learned what it really means to soldier, to care for soldiers, and to strive to protect the reputation of this great division. You all will be the judges of how well it went, and I look forward to your critiques in the months ahead. It's been a privilege to lead this great division, and one I now look forward to entrusting to Jon Jensen. The right analogy can be difficult to come by, but its search is often rewarded with meaningful result. Anyone who knows Jon is aware that he is a talented Army officer, gifted tactician, and involved community leader. For those few who are unaware, Nebraska has a prominent college football team called the Cornhuskers. The Huskers have won more than 800 games, 5 national championships, 2 in the 70s and 3 in the 90s. The coach that led the team to the 2 championships in the 70s was Bob Devaney. Coach Bob, like me, was a fashionable fellow with his fedora and suit and tie. Unlike me, however, Coach Bob was known to enjoy a few cocktails after the game and liked to tell stories that many would say were best left untold. Like Bob Devaney, though, I am surrounded by truly great people, the caliber of Heisman Award winner Johnny Rogers and tough, hard-nosed people like Outland Trophy winners Rich Glover and Larry Jacobson. Like the Huskers prevailed over Oklahoma in the game of the 20th century, the Red Bulls are prevailing in the game of this century, contributing to our nation's warfighting efforts since 9/11. But for all of Bob Devaney's successes, he knew he would have to transfer the reins to a new leader with a fresh vision for the football program, and he turned it over to Tom Osborne. Tom Osborne, a Nebraska Army National Guardsman, went on to eclipse the success of Bob Devaney with 3 national championships. John, you are the Tom Osborne of the 34th Infantry Division. Quiet, mild-mannered, aw shucks kind of guy. Those that know Osborne the best, though, know that he burns with a single-minded intensity to achieve excellence. Your skill in developing leaders will bring about the best in our soldiers, and over time, you will develop your military version of Jarvis Redwine, Amon Green, or Grant Wistrom. And because Kevin wanted me to say this, keep your eyes open because you'll never know who will be your I am hip.
That's right.
Just as your fellow Big Red fans knew that Coach Osborne could be trusted to improve upon Coach Devaney's success, those that count on the Red Bulls know that you will advance our division's accomplishments in the future. Good luck, John. Most important, ladies and gentlemen, please know that anything I have or will accomplish is founded in the support and dedication of my family. To Cecily and Sam, thank you again for your willingness to serve with me for another tour. What I do would be meaningless without your acceptance. Cecily, you have never been the person who gets in the way of success. Instead, you have always been the person who fully supports it, who cheers for it, who can celebrate it equally, and oftentimes with the same pure amazement as others have had in my career. This was not your dream, but you always believed in me. Your mantra has always been, we will make this work, from the advanced course to Harvard to Iraq Times 2. Not one single no, not ever. And you instilled in Sam, who always encourages me to excel and has become someone who has made me a better leader and has also been the driver of my success. Sam, I will never forget your support through 3 absences and am mindful of your words to Mom after the last one when you said, Mom, we crushed this. We could be professionals at deploying. Son, I'm so very proud of your ROTC achievements and I look forward to the day that you are a lieutenant in the Great Red Bull Division. And perhaps, with a bit of luck, some help from Jon Jensen, you can serve for Jon while we all serve together in this great Army. Ladies and gentlemen, for all that's been said here today, for the list of achievements and the awards and the accolades, I'll leave you with the words of Carl Kurtz of the Wisconsin Kurtz clan, great outdoorsman and accomplished fisherman. Always leave it better than you found it, Neal. I think we've done that these past 3 years. This has been such a truly wonderful chapter in my life, and I am so thankful for all of you who have shared it with me. Thank you very much. Attack.
Ladies and gentlemen, the 34th Infantry Division Commander, Brigadier General Jon Jensen.
General Nash, General Loidolt, former division commanders, distinguished visitors, fellow Red Bull soldiers, family and friends of the 34th Infantry Division, thank you for your attendance today and your continued support of the 34th Red Bull Infantry Division and the Minnesota National Guard. I want to start off first and foremost by thanking everyone who made today's change of command ceremony possible. Colonel Mike Wickman and Command Sergeant Major John Lepowski and the division staff, Lieutenant Colonel Jess Ulrich and Command Sergeant Major Joe Johnson of the Headquarters Battalion, and of course, the 34th Division Band. Thank you for your preparation, your attention to detail, and your support. For all of you that have extended your well wishes to me and my family over the past few weeks, thank you. Your support and friendship is reassuring and reminds me of the many blessings I've received during my Army career. General Nash, thank you for your continued confidence in me and for providing me the opportunity to lead the great soldiers of this division. I know the legacy of the 34th Red Bull Division means a lot to you. Thank you for the opportunity to serve with our division again. I'd also like to thank Major General Joe Harrington and United States Army Africa Team in Vicenza, Italy for their support and their encouragement as I transition out of that incredible assignment. I'm transitioning about a year and a half early, and they have been nothing but accommodating and supportive of my new assignment. General Loidolt, it's amazing that Isaiah Moses Walter Hip, running back for the University of Nebraska, I am Hip, was mentioned in a speech by a U.S. Army general officer, and thank you for calling me Tom Osborne and not Bo Pelini. That was an incredible rundown of Nebraska football history, and I know Kevin Olson's probably responsible for that. You know, there's a couple other players you could have mentioned. I'm glad you didn't call me them either. But I am sincerely, sir, I am thankful for your mentorship, your friendship that you've shown me over the years. It's a privilege to follow you, sir. It truly is a privilege. I've been very lucky in my Army career. I have followed the great Paul Zimmerman into battalion command. Previously mentioned, great officer Eric Kerska in brigade command, and now, sir, the opportunity to follow you in division command. I am a very, very lucky man. I think this saying, and I'm not sure who said it first in the division, I don't know who coined it, but I've heard it before. I think this is a true testament to you, your command team, and the division that served you, and that's this phrase. The phrase of, there is no off-season for the 34th Infantry Division. That state of mind and that approach towards service accurately describes a culture that makes the Red Bull experience a truly unique experience, and I know it captures the way that you commanded the organization. There's two groups today that I'd like to focus my comments to. First and foremost is my family. My wife Cindy, Jake, Atlee, Keeley, my mom and dad, Roger and Diane, my youngest brother James and his wife Brenda, thank you for attending today's ceremony. Thank you for your continued support. But today it's very important to me to recognize my wife's contribution to this honor that I'm receiving. I not only want to thank my beautiful wife, Cindy, but I want to point her out as the true key of all of my success. She's a wonderful partner and a true teammate. She's an amazing mother to our three children, a wonderful and caring daughter to her parents, a peacemaker and bridge builder among her siblings, a doting aunt to her nieces and nephews, and the rock that all of my shortcomings and deficiencies fall upon. For years, she's carried these for me faithfully and without complaint. God gave me a strong wife with a big heart because he knew I needed one. God also gave me a wife with a great deal of patience because he knew that I would test that patience. Cindy's been such a supporting and nurturing influence in my life. Every time an opportunity or a challenge arose for me, she was there to gently encourage me to go for it, all the while knowing that she would have to carry some extra burden and spend a little more time without me. I love you, Cindy. Thank you for everything you do for me and for your love. The second group, of course, are the soldiers and leaders of the 34th Infantry Division. 92.5 years ago, a gentleman from my hometown, or I should say, from his hometown, took command of this division. His name was Matthew Tinley, and he commanded the 34th Division from July of 1924 to March of 1940, almost 16 years. So I'm the second native of Council Bluffs, Iowa, to command this division, and probably the similarities between Matt Tinley and I stop there. Because if you would make a list of the top 10 leaders this division has had of all time, he certainly would be on that list. He was a great citizen of his city, of his state, and of his nation. In addition to 16 years of division command, he left medical school in 1898 in order to deploy with his Council Bluffs National Guard unit, the Dodge Light Guards, to the Philippines during the Spanish-American War. He was a first sergeant upon the mobilization and later received his commission during that deployment. After completing medical school, he left his medical practice in 1916 to deploy to the Mexican expedition with his unit, now named the 168th Infantry. And in 1917, he left for France and World War I and ultimately commanded the 168th Infantry Regiment in France as part of the 42nd Rainbow Division. After World War I and the reorganization of the National Guard, the governors of Iowa, Minnesota, North Dakota, and South Dakota selected him as the division commander, and the division headquarters remained in Council Bluffs during his time as the division commander. In addition to all this, he was also known as a caring and giving physician, particularly to the poor and the war veterans of his city. He would serve as the president and vice president of the National Guard Association of the United States. He was the first state commander in Iowa for the American Legion. He had an elementary school named after him, and in 1932 was strongly considered by FDR as a vice presidential running mate. Because General Tinley and I share the same hometown and now share the experience of commanding the 34th Infantry Division, I've been thinking about his life and his service, and he was a unique, special person. But I've also been thinking about how General Tinley's example, his legacy, and his spirit are alive and well in our current Red Bulls. Many of you have put your education and professional careers to the side in order to serve your nation, and for many of you to do so multiple times. You haven't hesitated when called, and you remain in service, prepared to do so again. Many of you are active in your local communities, committed to serving a wide array of people and organizations, working towards improving the lives and lot of those less fortunate than you. Fellow Red Bull leaders and soldiers, I am truly honored to lead you and to serve with you. I am privileged to once again have the opportunity to stand with the fine men and women of the storied 34th Red Bull Infantry Division. And a little more than 3 years ago, upon this very stage, I heard a division commander say, "Being a professional soldier is the most noble and selfless thing that our young men and women can do, I challenge you to continue to strive for excellence and be effective leaders. Sir, I say challenge accepted. Thank you again, friends of the Red Bull Division, for attending today's ceremony. We remain Army strong, always ready. Attack, attack, attack. Thank you.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the benediction by Chaplain Wynn and the retiring of the colors.
As Moses parted company with his brother, he offered this blessing, which I commend to you. May the Lord bless you and keep you, make his face to shine upon you and be gracious to you. The Lord turn his countenance to you and give you peace. And as you go, I pray that you serve your God and one another in love. Amen.
Ladies and gentlemen, please remain standing for the March of the Red Bull Legions, followed by the Army Song led by Sergeant Signe Munfrum and the departure of the official party. The words to the Army Song can be found in your program. Thank you for your attendance. This concludes today's ceremony. We'd like to invite the Jensen family and all of the former division commanders to join us at the stage for a photo opportunity. There will be a reception immediately following in the band room and the TAC atrium. All are invited to attend.
Jensen!